the reason my parents are getting a divorce.
I love my father and my mother so much that I don't want to lose them.
When I was 9 years old, divorce affected me. I remember crying myself to sleep every night. I thought my world was ending.
I wish I'd handled my divorce better. My grown children still have the emotional scars of our divorce.
My mom and dad don't have any idea how sad I am because they're too busy arguing.
When my parents got divorced, I got to see my dad a few times, but I still feel sad and I try not to think about it.
For 8 years, I battled depression and had attempted suicide, all due to the pain, anxiety, and anger of my parents' divorce.
Divorce is really a problem today in our society. It seems as if there was an epidemic of children and parents being affected by divorce. We know that 57% of all children in the classroom have divorced or divorcing parents. And this leads to all kinds of behavioral and emotional problems. Children often have long-term scars unless their parents are helped and are able to really bond with their children and see what's happening in their children's lives.
On the southern Kona coast, the Big Island of Hawaii, there's an ancient Hawaiian place of refuge. It was a sanctuary for those who had broken one of ancient Hawaii's intricate system of kapu, or taboos. If a person survived and made it to this place, he or she would be offered shelter and forgiveness by the kahuna, or traditional teachers.
Today, the place of refuge is a national park. In our film, it is a metaphor where millions of divorcing parents are invited to go and become aware of just how traumatic divorce can be for their children and to acquire the necessary skills, not only to end the marriage more peacefully, but also how to make the divorce less traumatic for their children.
Pu'uhonua literally means hill of earth. But functionally, Pu'uhonua was a place of refuge. It was a place where warriors would go to heal. It was a place where children, women, and the elderly would go for protection when they were scared or when they were in a position of being hurt. The Pu'uhonua, that place of refuge, is an extension of the concept of ohana. It's an extension of the concept of family. It's like going to grandma's house, that safe place when mommy and daddy is fighting or arguing. There you have people who are ready and willing to take you in, to care for you, to hear your pain, to counsel with you, to give you good advice. And when they feel you have the strength to return, then they'll send you home. So ohana and pu'uhonua are very closely connected because the pu'uhonua is basically the extension of family. It is a place that our own chiefs have used. And every child, every woman, man, individual should have a place of refuge, a place they can go to call their sanctuary, a place where they can go and be spiritually uplifted, be forgiven, and basically reconnect to themselves. And that's what the pu'uhonua was in ancient times.
It is generally recognized that divorce is epidemic in American society. The United States Census Bureau estimates that 40 to 50% of all marriages will end in divorce, meaning that almost one in every two marriages will fail. The increasing divorce rate has had a profound impact on society. After all, the family unit is the foundation of American society. When families come undone, cracks in that foundation are sure to appear. The disintegration of the family unit is leading to increased crime rates, increased drug use, juvenile delinquency, and to moral degradation of society in general. Although divorce has enormous negative effects on society, the most devastating effects are on individual flesh and blood human beings, parents and children, for whom life has taken a sudden and terrible turn. Love, trust, and loyalty are often all hurled out the window, leaving anger, guilt, self-doubt, confusion, even desperation.
Up until the early 1970s, divorce was a rare phenomenon in this country. Not that the marriages were any better, but people stayed together regardless, and divorce was rare. After the so-called revolution of the 60s, it became more permissible to be divorced in this country, and the dam sort of broke, and many people went out and sought divorce where that had not happened before. So there was kind of a deluge. No one wrote any books or did any research into the effects of divorce on children because it was brand new. Now, you know, we've got 30 or 40 years experience, and we can follow the lives of these children, not just right after the divorce, but how it affects them in their 20s and their 30s and their 40s. We're finding that things don't end just right after the divorce and everyone goes about their business.